Hey, we are back in Wrath of the Righteous. I've cleaned out everything except on the cusp of the abyss. All of the quests that have to be completed in this chapter are done. All I have to do, hopefully, is talk to the hand of the inheritor. Check the journal here. Oh, okay. I don't have the key to the Abyss Barriers on me at the moment. Because that's an Arelu Vorlesh thing. From her laboratory. Put most of those things in here for safekeeping. All those notes from Arelu's laboratory. I get for squirreling them away for so long and basically forgetting about it.
Watch out for trouble.
Okay. And the fact that it actually keeps track of that. Okay. Okay. Okay, we asked all the questions already.
I'm up for an adventure.
Okay. Pretty sure the barrier is here, I just don't see anywhere to interact with it. Maybe I have to research the key or something? Wait for the queen to arrive, huh? Okay. I get the picture. More paperwork. Army approaching, Demon army. this demon army. Another army, just the one. It gives me directions on. See anything else? So just the one. Kind of disappointing. No, we're not going to let you. Every single penny we can wring out of these demons. Let's see. Shaboom. So much for the fake fairy. Survive one round. Managed to knock down one vampire. Clerics, huh? Thank you. I want my mummy. Types. Okay, let's okay. Show up on the streets? That's where it's telling me to go. It's like, where is the queen? Why is she taking so long to get here? Not like we didn't tell her about this well ahead of time. Nothing new? Fine. All right, let's go. I should set up my group for the first foray into the abyss. Good. maybe good, but a tank would be better. I got my new Blood Rager. I haven't done anything with the Blood Ranger yet. Let me bring him along. We got healer, DPS, and a tank. So. I gave that guy that Sword of Gorum and made him a specialist in greatswords. So that should be interesting. Come on, mummy. Sure, there's only four of you now, but there'll be more. Yeah, we don't want to do Xanthar's experiments. It's just I don't plan to become a swarm that walks. And there's no benefit to this. It lowers your crusade morale and destroys 500 points of units. Morale's starting to go down there. We can't conquer any more keeps. Let's see, so supposedly every time I defeat an army in these areas, it should the banner of victories should turn green. However, I just defeated an army. And it's still red, so. Morale is gonna suck. It's gonna suck, I tell you. Oh, yeah, every day it's going down by 5? Yeah, it's we need to beat up some demons. That's what things like this are for. But we're busy researching dragons, so. Approaching. Is it now? Okay. We'll let it get a little further this time before we kick it down. Okay, Grandolph will sit out of this one. Oh, besieged. Well, that means I need to speed it up now. Who's closest? That would be Gladriel. Gladriel, would you kindly go and kick their butts? Get for being a cowardly demon army. Okay, now then. You scare me. Go away. Excellent. Undead don't care about the stink. Low morale thing. Nobody wants to move. At least the undead don't have morale. Finish that dragon thing. Let's that, now we're only a little bit negative. we don't want to use this until we're absolutely. I think I'm going to wait to use this until after the next chapter. Because you can only use it once. And if I recall correctly, Queen Galfrey is not all that when it comes to running a crusade. Okay. Okay, so we don't have any dragon units at the moment, but oh, that's finances. That's not. I thought that was morale. So none of this is going to increase morale. Oh well, at least we can do that. That's what I get for not unlocking any of those decrees. Okay, let's yeah, I did a lot of building. That raised my skills up. I think I've already got all of strategy. Yes. So, oh, it did tell us. Energy points. So yeah, we don't need that here. Thing is, all of our training things have adjoining buildings already, so pointless to build one of those. Energy, we could build more hospitals, that'll increase the size of our. Why don't we just do that? I mean, we could lose more troops without fully losing more troops. I'll leave this one big space open. I think there are some buildings you can only build in the next chapter, so. Where's the queen? Is she just mocking me by not showing up? Alright, let me. Upgraded this one to the next level so we can build more stuff here. We can put a monument here. Da-da-da. Yeah, it's there's no space big enough to put one of those. Alright, so watchtower. Okay, we're all built up. All right, let's even show up? Is Gelfry even a thing anymore? We've certainly been waiting a while. Oh, nope. Nope, 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 nope. Okay, maybe we have to go do something? As soon as I leave the city, she's going to show up, right? Let's see. I think... did I ever go back and talk to the kobold? I don't think so. Fine. We'll go do that. We'll say hello to the kobold. Hello, kobold. I think we can invite him to the city, and then we don't have to come back here for advice anymore. Maybe we can ask the kobold, hey, why is Queen Gelfry taking so long to get back to us? Hey, Grinka. Okay, so hopefully that will move him to Dresden. I guess I got a new, okay. They're expensive. Hopefully I don't have to wait for that one to be finished. Okay. Where are you, Galfrey? Going down the crapper. Just you're dragging your heels. Let's go talk to the hand of the inheritor. Maybe he has some news. Twist his head. Throw him in the trash. Oh, no. No new. It's like, come on, Galfrey, where are you hiding? Okay, everybody's tired now. We didn't even get to fight. Alright, let's load Team Vampire. There's no healer in that group, but I don't think he really counts as a healer, except for undead, but they're all undead, so. Oh. Didn't lock in. Okay. Closed it instead of singing freaking okay. Alright. Goods. That's my new blood rager. Alright, now then. We got Stevens coming in. Uninvited guests, have we? They attacked me and they want to run away. I'm not going to let them run away. This looks very familiar. Take this. She hasn't learned fireball yet, but... Stinky little fart demons. What? Panic. You're a zombie. How does a zombie panic? I mean, they're not known for their intellectual capacity, you know? and they go, brains. Still didn't count as a victory, hmm? Morale is going to be completely in the toilet if Galfrey doesn't get here soon. Let's see now. All right, that would work really well for a lich, wouldn't it? Intelligence for damage bonus? I'm like, yes, please. I really like this one. Lowers morale. Our morale is so low. What does the Swords of Set decree? Yeah, reduces morale. Just 500. Fine. Will be one semi-good thing. That's gonna take forever. Another demon army. Finance points. I don't need finance points. I need morale. Unfortunately, I don't have anything that increases morale. I have things that decrease morale. Like, Warriors of the Device. No. Maybe this will attract Queen Galfrey? I guess these armies don't count as armies or something. Oh, I can't get both of them, huh? Get both of those. Boom. What do the mummies do? Profane healing. Okay, I can now have a way of healing undead units. Still doesn't count as a victory. Let's see. We can improve it once, but that's not something we can repeat. We need a repeatable decree to increase our morale. If Galfrey shows up, it should show up under events, right? These armies I'm building up are all gonna disappear when they get to chapter 5. Oh, it renewed. so big. Too many archers. Oh, I saw an event pop up. Battle monsters. I don't need, I don't think any of this improves. Oh, okay. Improves morale. Okay. It's like, sorry, dude. We gotta try to keep our morale from hitting rock bottom. Guess I should have tried to unlock more morale-related decrees early on. When I was going, it's easy to keep your morale high. It's like, well, maybe not so much, huh? Ah. Every 30 days you can do this one. But it has to wait until this one's finished. So, yeah, I don't want to do either of those. Those both reduce morale. All right, let's, little these are getting overwhelming. I guess the gangs coming in don't count as a as an army. Aha! About time. I should let her cool her heels for a month or so. It's like, you made me wait.
Greetings to the leader of my crusader host. I must admit, I was astounded by what happened to the Sword of Valor under the influence of your power. After arriving, my first concern was to visit the relic and pray before my goddess's banner, only to discover that it was no longer her banner. However, we have more pressing matters to discuss at present. I received regular reports about the course of your activities. And I wish to take a moment to publicly thank you, Knight Commander. Your victories as a military commander are undeniable and will not be forgotten.
Ooh. Like, wanna be snarky?
I am pleased that we happened to meet and work together on this one matter, Commander. We will discuss future plans and military objectives later. Now, for the main purpose of my visit. The Hand of the Inheritor summoned me here. He believes that you will require my help when you attack the Midnight Fane. A Demon Lord Temple virtually on top of a Crusader stronghold. No one could have predicted it. The sooner we bring it down, the better.
Let's see. No, I'm not going to show her that. That's my belt buckle now, not yours.
Of course. We reclaimed Drezin. This is a significant achievement for the Fifth Crusade. It was the moment when we proved that we could win. But we must take the next step. We must capture a valuable asset of the enemy. The Fane is the ideal target, because it will allow us to eliminate the threat hanging over Drezin and destroy a key outpost of the Abyssal armies in one foul swoop. That is why I am here, and why I shall be going on the attack with you. Calm. And by that I mean like the calm before the storm. We fended off an attack on Rosian, and since then, aside from a few skirmishes on the frontier, we have seen neither hide nor hair of any demons. There is good news as well. Word of the Fifth Crusade's victories is spreading far and wide, inspiring new volunteers to join our ranks. The Church of Iomedae has received a record number of donations, which are now being used to keep your forces fed and armed. We are growing stronger, and we have to believe that this newfound strength will be enough to win this war. No! I put you in charge of the Crusade, and therefore I must trust you. If you want my advice, ask Lady Kenomi. Her words are my own. I don't wish to boast, Commander, but on my own I'm worth as much as a whole troop. Besides, I feel that I am needed here, and my blade has sat in its scabbard long enough.
Both of these are bad ideas for a lich.
We must send the people of Drezin to take shelter, and you must inform all of your companions. The hour is upon us.
Yes, yes. Okay. I'm going to bring the undead. Can't bring the tired people. They're all still tired. Where did they get a free rest? I didn't. Alright, so let's see. We've got Duok. We need a witch. Okay, that should do for the Midnight Fane. I may need to rest halfway through it, but we'll do our best. Kaboom! Like, yeah, with the big explosion, I'm pretty sure that they're well aware that we're here. Ready for battle! Master bidding us welcome. Alright. In we go. Derrid is just sort of hovering there with his wings, now that he's got wings. Like, yeah, I am Gallifrey. Okay, we finally get to see the Hand of the Inheritor in actual battle instead of just behind a force field. Go right after the boss, do ya? Impressive.
Kill is for you.
I really should delay everyone's actions to get them together in a group. That way the NPCs can do their thing, and then I can just do my thing. Boy, they really want to go for Louie, don't they? Alright, so... spells right now. I really should just shoot people. Okay. Oh, let's move out of attack of opportunity range first.
Out of my sight!
Okay, she's got that cold aura thing going on. But, still a good idea to get out of attack of opportunity range. Let's pull out a battle companion.
Just have to resort to brute force.
I'll rip you apart.
Alright.
Ha!
Got a better weapon. Well, right now we need armor class. This one go defensive as well. Uh-oh. He did not get a rest. He's gonna need one. Alright. He is really, really short on spells. At the very least, he should get a sea mantle going. That will help defend him. Everybody's got spells but the boss.
And grace.
Yes!
Alright. Cannot teleport. Okay, so...
Trust in yourself.
Gonna do some duration cheesing on the because if we do this, then we can get everybody defensed up. We could build the duration up. Like a minute, that will allow us to move around and have protection started at the beginning of each fight. Okay, so start with 6 seconds duration, as you can see, it is fairly easy to build it up. Because we're going to need to defend the leader until we use up all of our magic, and then we can do a rest. Okay, where's Galfrey? Galfrey, where are you? Am I supposed to talk to Galfrey?
There are many roads to success.
Soot is restless. I wonder why.
We have no pets in this group, so I need to be ultra careful.
Huh? What's that?
That is a trap. Betting that in order to disable it, we need to get... Yeah, okay. Nobody has trap skill. Oh. It was already open. Okay.
I sense something.
We're just gonna have to be careful.
I see something over there.
Let's get our marching order set up properly. Do not want Windog in the lead. And, this is not a good group, actually. I think I goofed. Staunton is not exactly tanky.
I will guide.
Okay. Conserver.
I will practice my combat ability.
Nango, we remember you. Okay, let's start with a blade barrier.
I'll rip you apart.
Regular skeletons, but we're not in range to put them on the other side of the barrier right now, so. Let's put that on Ember. Okay, so half of those are just going to walk through the blade barrier and die. You suck. Let's go till he fails to save, see what the damage is like. Okay, he's got too much defense. Let's lower his armor class and cackle.
So it comes to this.
Oh, I should check my inventory for that special axe. One that uses intelligence instead of strength and dex.
I'll make short work of this. Choice.
Who stands in the blade barrier? That's not a good idea.
Out of my sight.
Be literally dead on his feet, so we built the duration up to a little over a minute. Let's see if this hurts him. Has that reborn ability thing going on?
No fear.
Yes, stand in the blade barrier, dum dum.
I will see to your demise.
He's still standing, but he just shrunk.
Missed okay. Me already.
Alright, so we've got a group that has an issue. It's got no No lock pickers. I mean, we can use, I wonder if I could go back and change my party. I don't think I can. I think I'm stuck with them. So, huge pile of corpses. Okay, let's check our inventory. Got that new axe, which I can't use because it's a pick. So I would have to take a feat to use martial weapons. It was a thought. I'm already overweight as it is. We're carrying too much stuff. Okay. Fine.
Anything for you.
Staunton! Just gonna be stuck on the other side of the barrier. Ember got pushed through the barrier too.
I'll rip you apart.
Okay. Without a lock picker, this is going to be very, very hard. I'm going to reload a save from before we went in here. Okay, this must be the autosave when she showed up, so I'll have to rethink my group a little bit. Because with the inability to open locked doors and things, it's going to be very, very hard. At least I know I'm not going to get a free rest going in. So, Galfrey is here.
Well, are you ready?
Okay.
We must.
Okay. This time, we'll make sure we have someone. sure we do have the ranged folks and a witch. However, we absolutely need somebody who can pick locks. Camellia is our go-to in that department. So, plus, she has that nice tanky pet that we could use to block doorways. So we had one false start. It's surprising, though. I've trained trickery on so many of my characters. I just happened to pick the ones with no trickery. Always must be mindful of group composition. Give us a chance to put Camellia on her mount. Okay. Fine. Ouch. Okay, let's wonderful. She choked. She choked on her rolls. I kind of love the fights where they don't let you set up your own formation. Okay, time to step back, Louie. Actually, let's get that sea mantle going. That's another thing it didn't let me do before we started.
I'll rip you apart!
Oh, well, that was not good. All right, it looks like I'm going to have to do it again. I should have had her step back. Those things have basically unlimited attacks of opportunity, so every time she attacked... So I thought she had the feat that prevented attacks of opportunity from throwing axes, but I guess not. Gonna have to check her feats next time she levels up. When she gets feet.
Well,
okay, here we go.
We must send.
Okay, definitely need those two. And her. And which is which? Let's try the Snow Queen this time. Camellia is going to be our tank, assuming that I can survive the first round. Game setting up my formation for me, putting me in easy attack range of all those enemies. I wish it would autosave before the fight. Why can't it put me in the rear? I was like, no, it's got to put me in the front. Right here. Where all these backstabbing enemies can... She didn't get to cackle.
They'll beg me to.
I shall survive this ordeal.
Okay, we've gone all full circle. get protection on Camellia. And of course he can't cast it. Nothing more annoying than casting a spell and having it just sit there.
Just have to resort to brute force.
Okay, I'm gonna stick with this group for sure, so... Thank goodness, huh? It's like one false start and a couple of attempts is bad enough. Okay, not reach her up on the mammoth? That's just... That's ridiculous. Ridiculous! Come on. Give me the heal and put it on Camellia. Thank you. Wish they'd fix that. Okay, Louis.
So it comes to this.
Louis. Oh, yeah. Louis.
You are today's sacrifice.
Okay. Okay, Delamere. Okay. There's Gallifrey. Hello, Gallifrey. All right, now then.
Watch out for trouble.
Now what is that?
An undisarmable trap.
Huh? What's that?
What do we have here?
Okay, let me save it here.
Open your heart to me. Now, what is that? I hope you appreciate this.
And the other trap is in aggro range of the enemies, so I'm just gonna have to... Why don't we pull them back to this doorway?
Where do you want me?
I do things my way.
Oh, skip the pleasantries.
Does anyone require my counsel?
Okay.
Well?
We shouldn't need a blade barrier for this fight. Oh, look, a pile of corpses. Gotta love that area of effect fear aura that she's got now. Makes things so much easier. Okay. First batch of skellies. Toward the end of this area, there's a battle where we're gonna need all the skeletons we can get. So
they'll beg me to stop.
This will be a question of we're gonna need a rest at that point. Okay, Snorky. Okay, an invisible one was just walked up there. See the distortion as it moved. Got a couple of invisible ones right there. Caused him to fall down. Oh, Snorky hit him and hit him with a trip. Like, hello.
You've made your choice.
Out of my sight.
Back a bit.
I'll rip you apart.
Go for their heart. In crimson.
Okay. like, hey, you guys back there, you wanna, I don't know, help out or something? Okay. No spells from that position. Take a step back. Still got plenty of skeletons out there. Let's see.
No match for me. I'll cut you wide open.
He already got one. Oh.
I will see to your demise.
They'll beg me to stop.
I must replenish my powers.
Okay. I'm gonna save after this fight and take a dinner break. At least I am now in the Midnight Fane. It took us like an hour of waiting Galfrey to show up, but now at least we've got a good start on it. So let me save the game here at the end of this fight, and I shall resume perhaps later tonight, maybe tomorrow, depending on events. Things could happen. IRL is a thing. So you guys have a good evening, and we shall see you when we see you.